Yo, what up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. I did a video a while ago on multi-select and select all parameters in a paginated report, but I kind of stumbled across this little thing when you use the get data feature when you're building a paginated report. This makes it so easy, and I want to show you. All right, so you know what I like to do? Enough of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. Okay, I designed this paginated report, and if I run it, let me show you. I could choose a single value. I click view report and it'll load Canada. If I switch it up to France, I get the details for France. Now, the requirement is, hey, I want to select more than one country from that list and output it. How do you do that? Well, I found a really easy way. And Alex Powers and Pat Mahoney, these Power Query experts, they're probably going to laugh when they see this video. But I thought this was pretty cool and pretty easy. Let me show you how I set this up. I created this report. And so I just created a view out on my SQL server that returned all the information. You'll see this view again in a later video. So I created that and I set up my data set using the get data feature. And initially when I set it up, let me show you what I did. If I go into data set, I created a parameter that binds to this data set. So you can see I have customer invoices and I created a parameter right here for that country. And then what I did was I went over here and I set a filter. You can see my filter that I set, and the filter is equal to that parameter value. Okay. So you choose right here, select parameter, and it's equal to that. And once I did that, you can go back over to this. You'll see there's my parameter for country. If I go to my data set properties and go to parameters, you can see I associated the parameter for that data set with the parameter value. And now when I run it, that's how it passes that value from the parameter into the Power Query, filtering the Power Query based on that selection. But I want to do multi-select. How would you do this? Watch, it's so easy. And it was so fun when I figured this out. So I'm going to go back here and go right here into the get data. And I'm going to change this parameter. So I'm going to go manage parameter. And I'm going to change this from type text to type list. And then right here, I'm going to type two values. I'm going to type France. And then if you press enter, it'll let you type another one. I'm going to type United States. Okay. So if I click OK, and then if we go back to our data set, it's not going to return anything, because what you need to do, and this is the magic right here. So you go to that filter, you click the gear, and then you change this from equals to in. Now, this is not available in the desktop yet, but it's definitely available in the online Power Query editor. So I choose in, and now I say equal to that country. So I click OK, and then watch this. Watch, if I go over here and I choose my drop down, you'll see two countries, France and United States. If I go back to the list and delete the United States and click apply and I go back, you can see it's only France. And so I switched it from an equals to an in because it's accepting a list. And so my thought was, if I go back to my report, change my parameter from a single value to a multi-value, it's going to pass it in. Let's see if that works. So now we're going to go back here, choose create, and then I'm going to go over to country, my parameter, and I'm going to change it to multi-value. That's all I'm going to do. And I'm going to click OK, and I'm going to run my report. And we're just going to choose Australia for now. Click view report, sit back and wait to see what it returns. So a single page, just Australia. And so now I'm going to add France and Germany to this. So let's see what happens. And look at, there are multiple pages. There's Australia, there's Germany, and there's France. And all I did was go into the get data experience in the paginated report, change my parameter from a text to a list. And then in my filter, instead of equal, I use that in option and set that in equal to my parameter, which was a list, and then bound them on my paginated side. So now I can do a multi-select, so easy. All right, what do you think? I don't know how I missed this. Have you seen this? Have you used this? Do you have any questions about this? You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to learn more about Power BI or Fabric, there's probably a video flying above my head. And as always, from Martha, Adam, and myself, thanks for watching. And we'll see you in the next video.